All right, guys, ZFR back once again. So we're finally going to get to talk about The Last of Us Part 2 spoilers in this video. If you want a spoiler-free video, I did one yesterday, so go check that out if you don't want spoilers. That's your only warning. I recommend getting out of here now because this junk's about to get real. So, yeah, getting into this, The Last of Us Part 2 has pretty much been leaked completely. The entire story plot is out there. You know, you have some people just try and brush it off as a couple bullet points and there's going to be way more to it. No, listen, people, the entire game has been leaked just about. Or at least all the main plot points that connect everything in the game, the overall story, which despite what some people want to believe is the main component in a game like The Last of Us. The gameplay is fun in The Last of Us 2, don't get me wrong, even though some people might disagree. It's fun, but the story is the main point, and that's been leaked, and sadly, a lot of people aren't happy about what they saw. A lot of people are very, very upset with this story leak. And I can't blame them. It's a pretty bad one. Like, this story, if this is actually the story of The Last of Us Part 2, oh man, this sounds bad. Now, I'm not going to go over every single part of the leak, because the truth is, there's certain things that are flowing around out there that you might have not even seen yet. Like a lot of people, I wonder how many people saw the small little clip of Jesse's death that even leaked. I don't know how many of you saw that clip, but that was the last one I saw, and that came out of nowhere. I thought I was done seeing stuff until that one popped up. So yeah, there's all kinds of clips out there and stuff, but overall, let's just get into like the main stuff. So the big one is that the new transgender character, Abby, kills Joel, right? She kills him, and then not only does that happen, but you're forced to play the second half of the game as her after she brutally murders Joel with a golf club. Like, bruh. Bruh, Naughty Dog, what are you doing, man? What are you... Oh my god, no. And then if that's... Now, here's the thing. This wouldn't be as bad if you got to play as Ellie the second half of the game and you got to hunt her down and give her what she deserves. But no, you know what happens instead? You have to play as Joel's murderer for the second half of the game and you have to hunt down and track down Ellie to kill her too. Oh my god, guys. This... plot, I'm sorry, but fans have a right. They have a fundamental right to be pissed off with this plot, people. It's just a no-go. It is 100% a no-go. And you know, there's other little side stuff like the Ellie and Dina stuff, Dina being pregnant with Jesse's baby, but you know, Jesse's dead now, so I guess Ellie and Dina are going to start a family or whatever. Or they already have by the time the game ends. The baby's already been born and stuff. And apparently, from what I'm hearing, the game ends. Now, some people are saying Ellie dies at the end of the game. I don't know if that's true. That's actually not confirmed. People, for people who heard that is not confirmed. From what I'm seeing, it looks like Ellie does not die at the end of The Last of Us Part 2. From what I saw, it looks like she survives. And what I'm hearing is that the game actually ends with Ellie going back out after Abby a second time. And this time around, when she goes after her, from what I hear, that's where the game's going to end. And it's going to end off with Abby as the protagonist, and for the third game, Ellie is going to be the antagonist for Last of Us Part 3. So, yeah, there's just obviously a lot of stuff bad about this plot. A lot of really bad stuff here, man. Where do I even start with this? I don't even know what to start. Let's just start with the biggest problem I have with this entire thing. My problem is, you spent the first game completely building up Joel and Ellie's relationship, that's what made the first game. That's what made gaming history, right? You know, the first, there were plenty of story games out here, but The Last of Us was the first real big story game to really focus around structuring the entire plot around two characters developing a bond, a relationship. And only for you to completely disrespect and crap all over that bond and try to turn the fans against it after all of that build up? Guys, I don't know about this one. I do not know about this one. So, basically, this means that I have to watch Joel, one of the best characters in gaming currently, get beat to death brutally by this transgender chick. And then, and just for all the people out there, it doesn't matter that she's transgender, okay? It really doesn't. People are trying to spin it like that's the main problem people have with this leak. No. Okay, no, it's not. The problem is that she kills Joel, and then they try to make her into the hero of the game. They try to turn her into the protagonist and turn Ellie into an antagonist. Nobody wanted that. Nobody wanted that going into The Last of Us Part 2. That is a fact. Alright, who the heck wants to hunt down Ellie in The Last of Us Part 2? We thought we were going to be playing as Ellie in The Last of Us Part 2. When they said this was a story about hate, you know, I didn't think they meant like this. Oh my, like it's like the story literally tries to incite hate for the game itself, all right? Like, I don't know how some people are going to make it through the second half of this game. Now, me personally, I'm still going to get the game. I'm still going to play through it. I don't like the direction this is in, but you know, I'm a big believer in see everything for yourself before you completely 100% believe everything else. However, this looks pretty final, guys. Like, this looks pretty final, and I know with how sensitive some people are nowadays, there are going to be some people who are not going to be able to finish this game once it switches over to Abby. Alright, there's some people who are just going to put the controller down and be like, no, I'm not doing it. I'm turning it off. I'm throwing the game away. I'm going to sell this game. I'm not doing that. Alright, you know, this is just really bad. I don't know why they would think this is a good idea. I mean, we know why. It's this SJW stuff again, man. That's what it really is. And, you know, I gave Naughty Dog, I gave Neil Druckmann a little bit too much credit. You know, even though he's been kind of slowly going down this path, you know, he's never been this bad. Not to this level. I mean, I guess you can say you could have seen it coming with some of the things he used to say, or, you know, how he was kind of building towards it. I first noticed that he might be a little too SJW when in Uncharted 4, all the women all of a sudden looked like men all of a sudden. But man, I didn't think he was going to go this far, man. Like, and for all the people who are wondering why social politics and get woke, go broke is being brought into this, just look at how it's set up, people. Do you think this story would be the same if Abby was not a transsexual? Do you think this story would have been the same? Do you think they would have put her as the new main protagonist if she was a white male or a dude in general, or even a normal woman, I would say? You think they would have tried to turn the fan base against Joel and Ellie and paint them as villains? When after all that time we spent with them in the first game, don't get me wrong, Joel and Ellie technically are kind of, they're not exactly heroes, but you know, we don't care about Abby and her story. We spent the first game with Joel and Ellie, screw that hoe. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, nobody's trying to sympathize with her and you know, justify her murdering Joel. No, we want to kill her for murdering Joel, God darn it. We want this game to end with her death. That's one of the things that really gets me about this too, is that from what I'm reading, not only does she win, but she just gets to walk away. She just gets to walk away from one of the most heinous crimes in all of gaming. And I don't know, maybe they'll revisit that in the third game. But at this point, who's going to buy the third game? You know, at this point. Guys, come on, man. No, 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 no. Oh my God, I can't believe this. So just backtracking a little bit. So, from what the spoilers are saying, guys, I don't know if Ellie dies at the end of this game or not. Like I said, what I've seen so far points to the fact that Ellie might survive this game. The ending about her dying is not confirmed. I don't care where you've seen it, what you've heard. I've seen multiple versions of this so far. Like we don't know that yet. And that's the only bright part about this leak, is that Ellie might actually survive this game, which, God, I hope that's the way it goes. I really hope Ellie doesn't get killed by this chick, man. I really hope so. I really hope these spoilers are a little bit off, too, to be honest. I know there's not much hope. I know, like, there's a lot of evidence to back them up, and it looks pretty much like this is the way it's going to go. But there's a small part of me that just hopes somehow there's a mix-up, and I don't know, maybe we get to play as Ellie at the end of the game or something like that. But we know that's not true, because it's already been confirmed that the epilogue is going, you're going to be playing as Abby. We know for a fact that they are going to try to make Abby the new main protagonist, and nobody wants that after she kills Joel. Nobody wanted that before she killed Joel. Definitely not after. Alright, and once again, it has nothing to do with her being transgender. It's because The Last of Us was Joel and Ellie. Some people try to say that The Last of Us can be so much more than Joel and Ellie. Yeah, I see where you're coming from, but listen, if you're going to get rid of Joel and Ellie as the main characters, if you're going to move them out of plot, you could at least do it in a respectful way. You can at least do it in a way that the fans enjoy, that you can give them a proper send-off, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you want to switch the perspective of Last of Us Part 3, in my opinion, you should have at least had the decency. If you're going to kill Ellie at the end of this game, she should definitely get the kill on Abby. Definitely. The fact that they're trying to make this switch a route is insane. And once again, like I said, if it wasn't for this social politics stuff, this would not go down this way. Anybody trying to say that this game would have ended the exact same way if you switched Abby's quote-unquote gender, it would end it the same way, I'm telling you, no. They are doing this purely because, and listen, some people are trying to deny that Abby's the transsexual that they were talking about. They confirmed there's going to be one in the game. They made a big deal about it. I don't see anybody else who fits the bill except Abby. Alright, because they didn't talk about that as if it was going to be some small character. They made it seem like a big deal, and this matches up pretty well to what they said a couple years ago in that interview. So, but let's just make it very clear that this is all just a ploy to put the first real big transsexual character at the forefront of one of the most popular gaming franchises of all time, or of this decade at least, or this generation, I mean, or technically last generation, but you get what I mean. You get what I mean, darn it. This is all just a ploy to put this social politics stuff center stage for us all to hate. And I'm a little railed up right now, but I mean, listen, man, it just sucks. And there's so many people right now who are already selling out. There's so many people who are just like, oh my God, it's Naughty Dog. They can't ever do anything wrong. Listen, if you have not read these leaks, if you are someone, the people out there that have not seen the spoilers, that have not seen the leaks, need to just be quiet, man, because there's no way they could ever guess that they are going to not only kill off Joel, but force you to play half of the game as the person who kills Joel and hunt down and possibly kill the other main protagonist to make room for this new main protagonist that just killed the Earth. Nah, bro. No. I'm not trying to have it. I just ain't. Alright guys, that's all I'm going to do in this video. This video is already about to get really long. And to be honest, I'm just still at a loss of words. This is the main... I talked about the main stuff that bothers me so far in the game. Like, this is the main stuff that definitely has me kind of heated. I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. Leave it down in the comment section below. You know, if you're all here, you're spoiled anyway, so it doesn't matter. Leave what you think down in the comment section. I just can't believe this. I'm probably going to make other videos on this, kind of going over smaller parts of the spoilers, piece by piece later on this week and stuff. But right now, I just need a break from this subject. I don't know. I'm just going to, you know, go dive into another game. I don't know, work on something. I just need a break right now from the Last of Us subject, because man, this sucks. This is a total betrayal to all of the fans, Naughty Dog. I can't believe they did it. Listen, like I said, I'm still going to buy the game, and I'm still going to see what it's like for myself, because who knows, maybe somehow, some way, we're all jumping the gun and it's better than we think it's going to be. I highly doubt it. I personally highly, highly doubt it. Okay, but who knows? We could stand corrected. But for now, it's not looking good. It's not looking positive. The new release date is June 19th. But yeah, we'll see, guys. We'll see. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Hit that subscribe button. I will see you on the next one. ZFR out.